alchemist astrologer, and this is your June forecast for Capricorn Sun, Capricorn Rising, and Capricorn Moon. You are represented by the Three of Swords and the King of Swords. So for some of you, there's a strong air influence that may be in your own chart, or somebody you're connected to may have strong air. This could be Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female, or just the traits of air. So there's some kind of frustration or heartbreak, or perhaps even some third-party interference issues surrounding perhaps a love triangle or somebody getting involved in your romantic affairs. And there's also this desire to handle things more effectively. So for some of you, you're making some important decisions, or you're connecting to people who have the authority to do so. This may be regarding some form of settlement, so you may be connecting to judges, lawyers, advisors, you may be in arbitration. Or again, you're feeling some kind of frustration with regard to your partner. It could be that there's been a breakdown in communication or negotiations between you and someone else. And it could be that you've received some kind of painful news and you weren't expecting this, and so you're not really prepared to deal with it. But for some of you, whatever you're hearing, you almost knew this. The writing was on the wall. In which case, you've resigned yourself to come up with a plan B and move forward. So for some of you, there's some kind of heartbreak or some harsh words that cut to the quick, or some frustration about handling some things more effectively. And for some of you, you know, the King of Swords represents the ability to make a decision, to be logical, to be analytical, and for some of you, those are going to be key qualities. But in other cases, perhaps there's a lack of intimacy. There may be difficulty expressing fully emotions. And so while this is someone who's very gifted at solving a problem, they're not necessarily the best at expressing themselves. So for some of you, there's something that you want. You're very determined about a goal, and yet you may be reticent to, you know, put what you need to say out there, or move forward, or your partner is doing that. So something about movement is being handicapped because of this reluctance. For some of you, you're having a connection to a person simply because it serves a purpose. Again, you're gaining some kind of counsel, advice, information, and so that connection is going to be short-lived because it serves a purpose and you're finished. But for others of you, you may be out of sync with your partner. It's become very challenging. The relationship is not as rewarding because you're not on the same page at the same time. In fact, you may be sending out some mixed signals. And there's a need to, perhaps for one of you, to open up more to love, to open your heart, to be more generous. And you may be making some decisions, and there could be some heartbreak because you're thinking about some of the memories, the good times that you had. And perhaps, though, there's some glorification of the past or some revisionist history taking place. So somebody could be looking at the better parts of something. Now, that may be helpful. You may be opening your heart up to love and trying to remember the good parts in order to move forward. But for others of you, there is some frustration, and maybe you decide to cut something off. You want to close off to those memories. Now, your partner is represented by the Three of Cups and the Page of Cups. So your partner wants to share their feelings. It could be that you're discussing something that may have to do with your children, or maybe you're dating someone younger. So you may feel like you want to socialize, or your partner does. Perhaps your partner is connecting to friends or going out, and maybe there's some kind of social invitation involved with that. So emotional matters are going to be important, but yet there's some kind of significant turning point with regard to your partner, for better or for worse. Whatever has been following a particular course, there's now going to be a change in another direction. And somebody's feelings may be changing. They may be expressing that. This may have to do with healing a situation. It could be healing physically, emotionally, whatever's necessary. There's a sense of shared prosperity or the seeking of that. And so you're in an opportunity where your partner has wants to offer something, some sentiment. You could be getting a love message, or you could be offering that to your partner. So there's a lot of sharing of information. But your partner is also perhaps looking at information that may not necessarily be of any worth. Your partner may be looking at, you know, something where truth was stretched a bit thinly or embellished or exaggerated. And so something is not quite as it appears. So somebody may be wondering what the direction of the relationship is. Perhaps they feel that the commitment that they thought was there is not as stable. There could have been some naivete, some gullibility. And it may tie to some fortunate stroke of luck. So somebody, there could be some social event where there's perhaps some third party interference, but this is something that wasn't necessarily expected. It's out of the blue, and maybe it's pleasant, an unexpected encounter or surprise where somebody maybe is more free with how they feel. They're sharing something. Perhaps they're even sharing a secret of some sort. Because normally this would mean somebody was being very private, but in this case they're being more free, less inhibited, very open about something. That could be good or bad. Now the romance is characterized by the moon and the six of coins. So again, there's something going on behind the scenes, some kind of secretive or clandestine element. Could be something that has to do with some change, because something about your romance is now in flux. They're changing situations. You may be getting some opportunities, or you may be facing some challenges, and those could be, you know, moving up and down like the sea. Your emotions could be in flux. So you could feel out of sync with your partner due to whatever is happening. Again, maybe there's some health issues or some issues surrounding finances, or somebody feeling as if they're not getting enough attention or what they deserve or what they're due. So there's a need to balance the scales, to rewrite something. And it could be that one of you is secretly perhaps giving your attention out to someone else, or that somebody is withholding some funds. One of you may be in charge of the finances, and one of you is making the decisions about what to give out, or you're giving something out in crumbs, whether that's money or emotions, or some of you may be keeping your partner dependent upon you. There's something about the power of having your partner need you or having to depend on you. And so you give as if it's generosity, and yet it's not quite as charitable as it seems on the surface. So you could be doing that, or your partner could be doing that. Now this is some kind of exchange taking place, either emotions, attention, money, knowledge, information. So somebody could be offering, there could be some exchanges that maybe they're under the table or behind the scenes, or there could have been something deceitful going on. But if anything has been hidden on your part or your partner's part, that is likely to come to the fore at this time. Now, for some of you, there's a new sense of purpose. You're becoming more conscientious about your relationship, about your personal life, and so you may be making some changes. There's the possibility of having some kind of emotional or psychological breakthrough because you're putting in more effort. You're being more conscious of what's necessary to improve a situation. And you may be looking at old patterns, past conditioning, childhood memories, things that may no longer serve you in this relationship. Your maternal instincts may also kick in. Either of you could be feeling very nurturing, very protective. You're definitely more security-oriented. And it could be to the point where something is creating a worry. Could be you're under financial stress or emotional stress. And as a result of that, one of you may be suffering. Could be depression, psychological situations, could even be physical, where you deal with something that's difficult to diagnose, things that are difficult to pinpoint, and yet it's that level of stress that's wearing on either of you physically. In fact, you may be expecting this bad news. There could be a foreboding feeling, a foreshadow of something to come where something's not right. You know that you're going to be told something that you don't like in connection to somebody that you love, or your partner is feeling that because you have a strong intuitive link. Your moods, you're very affected by the environment. You have a strong influence on your partner, or vice versa. So there is change, and you're going to have to be very vigilant in getting to the bottom of something. And again, maybe trying to redress an imbalance, either personally or between you and another person. So you have to make sure that you're not trying to escape, burying your head in the sand with regard to something. But also, you may need to step back occasionally to gain your bearing on a situation by finding something that is distracting or amusing or refreshing so that you don't strike out at your partner, you know, when it's not their fault. There's some revelation, something secretive, and it may have to do with a pregnancy. Maybe this is a child, somebody's given birth. Maybe this is, you know, as the result of a secret love affair. Could be somebody's pregnant, or could simply be there's a revelation that one of you is trying to start something new, perhaps a new romance, a new direction, but something new is in the works. The problem is there's some kind of worry that that ties to travel or communication. This is a lot of air energy, some anxiety. Could be remorse, could be regret that's keeping you up at night because of a situation. You're going over the options, the conversation, the outcome of a situation, and thinking about how you could have changed it or what you need to do to create something better. Could be that these are just unfounded fears. You have this stress, this nagging feeling that something's going to go wrong, but that may not be so. Others of you are definitely perhaps dealing with some kind of illness. It may be some form of suffering. Could be physically, emotionally. Somebody may be dealing with depression because they can't find answers, options, or solutions. But even though you may feel that your options are limited, you do have some. It's likely that either you or your partner are not considering everything available to you. Perhaps in the past, your pride kept you from moving in a particular direction. Or based on principle, you felt you couldn't do something, or you just didn't realize that a certain option was available to you. Now, you may find that, you know, you're worried or anxious to do something. Maybe you're anxious to communicate, or you're worried about talking, having this conversation. Maybe you find yourself involved with somebody who draws you into conflict or controversy, or you're worried about, you know, making a quick exit from a situation, or you're rushing to protect someone because there's some worry here about the choices. Either your partner is worried about you or vice versa, because one of you thinks that the other person perhaps is not making the best decisions and you want to, you know, give some input, and yet that is creating some kind of friction. So for some of you, again, you're involved with some kind of planning agency. You may be coming up with some quick solutions. You may be dealing with legal situations or paperwork. You know, somebody may be very forceful. Somebody may be very assertive or aggressive. And this causes some worry, or there's some anxiety about getting something going. But once again, something will be illuminated. Something is going to come to the light, something maybe disturbing, or where there's been some arguments, disagreements, some discord. And it could be, you know, where there's been a competitive edge. Somebody's trying to win at all costs. Or again, there's been some abuse. And in the extreme case, maybe even some physical abuse, some psychological abuse. So something is coming to the fore where there's been some toxic situations. Now, the underlying energy is this Knight of Pentacles. It may have to do with some unexpected income, working towards something, having the resources that are needed. Perhaps because this is the slowest knight in the deck, somebody has been slow to respond. Somebody's anxious to get something moving, and somebody's dragging their feet. Or even, you know, they don't have any ideas. There's a lack of imagination. This is a knight who's very focused on security. And in fact, there could be some third parties. This could be an indication of some kind of secret love affair. Issues of loyalty, devotion, providing. So you could be very focused on that. Maybe you're having interactions with people who are connected to wealth or finances. Maybe you're dealing with the bank or a financial institution or people who invest. So there are issues surrounding your security. And in fact, you're looking at what you value. What habits you have, and are they serving you financially, emotionally? So you're going to have a lot of patience during this period to work out the finer points, the details of a situation. And for some of you, this is going to mean, again, looking at your values, what you've been doing, taking for granted, whether that's your time, your money, your energy, or your emotion. And has it been a good investment? Is something going to come of it? Or is this something that's just simply going down the drain? And it ties to a romance, either one you're currently in or one that, you know, where you were connected with somebody. This is Earth energy. It may very well represent you or another Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Whatever it is, somebody feels like they've been left out in the cold. One of you may be frigid. There could be sexual issues of impotency or lack of libido in the romance. Or somebody has put the deep freeze. The relationship is cooling off. Somebody may feel abandoned. And left out in the cold. So those are issues that you're having to contend with. Now the advice is, my body is a lush garden and I am the gatekeeper. So you may have issues that pertain to health or sexuality, where you're looking at your body as a sacred temple, a vessel that is here to perform, and how you care for that body is representative of how you feel about yourself. Who you decide to open those gates to may be very important. The outcome is the Five of Wands and Strength. So some of you may be struggling. Could be you're struggling with physical strength. You're struggling in a romance. Maybe you're dealing with a Leo. This may center around your self-expression, your sexuality, your libido, your children. So you are struggling, and there's a lot of ego involved in this situation with your partner. It could be that, you know, you're in this power struggle. Either you're struggling with yourself and your own desires, or against your partner, where you're involved in some petty bickering back and forth. Whatever it is, if you can't make up your own mind about what you truly desire, you're going to find yourself in conflict with your partner until you're clear about what you want. You're trying to perhaps solve some problems, and the strength of a conflict or your ability to solve a problem is going to be important. So strength, physical strength, vitality, your strength of character, your strength of conviction, your leadership skills, your loyalty, your steadfastness, those are going to be issues that you're focused upon. And this strength card says you're going to have the fortitude to go the distance in a situation. And you're going to have to know what your true desires are about. The strength card means you have confidence, or you should be focused on that. This is about feeling comfortable in your own skin and your own self as in totality, the dark and the light. So for some of you, you may be trying to persuade your partner, steer something by perhaps wielding some kind of positive influence rather than being all out aggressive or bullying. But if you're using this card negatively, you may be temperamental and narcissistic. There could be a false sense of power, or you lack power. You can't claim it. So this is about whether you're in touch with yourself and what your fears are, where you're vulnerable. Some of you may be operating out of doubt, and you're making poor decisions because you fear that there's going to be some kind of retaliation, or somebody's going to strike back at you, somebody's overpowering you, they're stealing your power. It could be that you feel that you're not good enough, or attractive enough, smart enough. You don't have the power that you need. In other cases, this is about feeling that strength, being confident in yourself, and that you can solve a problem. Whatever it is, again, this is about some kind of struggle. And you have two cards that have to do with messages. So some of you, there may be a subliminal message or some messages from a hidden source, something behind the scenes or something put out there, just not outright. It's implied or inferred. The message is there and you know it, you feel it, but it may not be spoken. And it has to do with perhaps a message of love. Could be an invitation. This may come about through something written. Could be a text, an email, a phone call. But there is some kind of message or sentiment that likely centers around love that may be happening behind the scenes. Somebody may be trying to figure out how to put that out there. The strength of the message, how it's communicated may be important. It may be trying to solve some kind of problem in connection to that. Now you have two major cards, the Moon and the Strength card. So this could be your emotional strength, your psychological strength. And again, the strength of a romance, the strength of a connection to your child. So you have two keys that are going to help you unlock the challenge. And they're very similar. So this is doubly stressed. The Moon says you have to be vigilant, and the Strength card says you have to have fortitude. And so at the end of the day, you have to keep pushing forward to get to the bottom of something, to keep following your path. And the negative would be avoidance and fear. You're avoiding something because you're letting your doubt guide you. Now, some of you, this may center around a legal or court case or seeking protection, or you're involved, again, with a love triangle or third party where you're dealing with some kind of rival. Others of you, this may be about conflicting missions. These two knights are very different. The Knight of Swords and the Knight of Pentacles. The Knight of Swords wants to rush, and the Knight of Pentacles wants to slow things down. The Knight of Swords is analytical. He's thinking quick on his feet, and the Knight of Pentacles can be a little bit sluggish in his thinking. So that could be an issue. And it also centers around perhaps delegation of some kind of responsibility. It may involve mentoring, offering direction, seeking direction. You may be dealing with some kind of revolt within your circumstances, some kind of challenge, or it could be an attraction. But there's not a lot of movement because you're trying to figure out what to do. And again, it could be that there are issues where somebody's trying to recuperate, to recover, to figure out what's going to happen next. And maybe you have to put your frustration aside to go within to come up with some answers. But if you're trying to revive a dead issue or resurrect something that is beyond its expiration date, you're probably not going to get good results. Now, for some of you, simply you reached a plateau right now. Things are at a quiet mode. It doesn't necessarily mean the worst. It just means you're taking a break. It could be a welcome break, especially if you're comfortable with yourself, your circumstances, and where you are. You're not feeling as if this is some kind of omen just because there's not a lot of movement. But there is some frustration. Somebody's out of sync. There could be issues of deception where people are trying to deceive you, perhaps your partner, or you're deceiving yourself about a situation. And you've got to be vigilant about getting to the truth of something. So that could be important. And it ties around a contract, agreement, or a partnership where, you know, it could be sharing your feelings, centering around healing, shared prosperity, some kind of social function. And you're weighing your options. You're looking at where you have enough or you don't have enough. And again, that is emphasized by this Six of Coin. This is about having resources or not having them. who's got them, and are they sharing it, and what are the intentions? Is it to truly help or to keep you enslaved in some way? So you're weighing your options. You're having to navigate moods, circumstances, emotions, challenges, and keep a lot of balls in the air. You may be doing that skillfully, or you may be, you know, feeling this seesaw of emotion because of what's on your plate. There is a focus on work, productivity, producing something, fertility, whether that's a child, a project, a situation, a circumstance, something. You're seeking something tangible, some kind of results from your efforts, and it's tied to benefits that come through others or some kind of favor. So you may be offering that or you may be seeking that. And it also centers around perhaps some kind of promise that was made, and whether that promise was kept, or some kind of invitation to a social event. And whatever it is tied to the past and its current influence because of the past. So there's some attention to detail that needs to be, you know, you got to focus on something, working out those details. And the timing of a situation is critical. So it may be, again, there's this tension, this push-pull where somebody wants to rush, but somebody's dragging their feet about something. So there's some ambitious developments for you this month. There's a change in the plan. It ties to your sense of security, stability, being very assertive, taking some leadership in order to create the foundation for something. There may be some drama that you're dealing with related to expectations, or either, you know, getting something in gear and becoming very productive. You're trying to create circumstances that suit you as well as perhaps your partner or someone else involved. And it also ties to the future, opportunities that have an impact on your future, your destiny, and the people that are tied to that. All right, Capricorn, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit the notify bell button. Let's make some positive change in your relationship. Let's create a love revolution.